The Duterte family's candidacies for next year's midterm poll seen as a fight for survival by a political analyst. Professor Froilan Kalilung of the University of Santo Tomas says the family is seeking to keep its grip on Davao City by fielding former President Rodrigo Duterte for mayor. Kalilung says a loss in their own bailiwick could affect their potential bids in 2028. Now, the former Philippine leader will be up against his ex-cabinet secretary, Carlo Nograles, in the mayoral race.
If the Nograles will actually be able to snatch Davao away from the Dutertes, then it will give the idea of the weakening control of the Dutertes in their own bailiwick. And this may translate into a seemingly weaker perception of the electorate, of the voting public on a national level. And this is something that the Dutertes would not want to actually have.
Weighing on the general election picture for next year, Kalilong says it's time for measures against political dynasties, which he says has consequences for the country.
We are setting aside the idea of good governance, of public service, so that we will be able to accommodate political patronage. And this actually erodes the democratic fiber of our country, and the democratic spaces is being maligned to a great extent because of this political dynasty. So I really hope that there should be a way by which we could somehow regulate, if not mitigate, the ill effects of this political dynasty.
Foreign direct investment net inflows into the Philippines go up in July. Data from the Philippine Central Bank show it was at $820 million, up 5.5% year-on-year. Now, it was also the highest figure recorded since February this year. This brings the total FDI net inflow from January to July to $5.3 billion. That is 7.5% higher than what was recorded from the same period last year. The BSP points to rising non-residents' net investments in debt instruments for the increase. Capital infusions for the month were mainly from Singapore, Japan, and the U.S. A top Philippine business group is calling on firms to integrate programs aimed at helping society into their business model. The details from Jackie Pascual.
Some of the major companies in the Philippines signed a covenant on shared prosperity in Taguig. Organized by the Management Association of the Philippines, the covenant signing is aimed to encourage Filipino businesses to do more beyond the usual corporate social responsibility efforts. The group says there is a need to integrate programs to help society with business operations.
We need to respond to the reality of the heightened economic inequality and the adverse long-term effects thereof in our country. Encourage our member companies toward shared economic prosperity for all, environment and climate action, and principled business practices and governance.
Author and professor Robert Klitgaard shares an example of a global company which not only bought supplies from farmers, but also trained farmers to improve their farming methods. This led to more quality supplies for the company, while farmers earned more. The shared prosperity concept also means investing in employees and prioritizing the environment.
Shared value goes beyond philanthropy.
It calls on us to do more than simply run profitable businesses. It challenges us to build a society where prosperity is shared, inequality is reduced, and the environment is protected.
MAP hopes more companies will push for shared prosperity because it's a win-win effort. Businessman Ramon Del Rosario Jr. says companies can use their expertise to help a particular sector.
This is not about CSR or ESG. This is about reimagining business as a catalyst for addressing societal needs. Integrate shared prosperity into your core business goals. Identify basic societal problems that remain insufficiently addressed: homelessness, hunger, inadequate healthcare, to name just a few.
Speakers at the Shared Prosperity Summit say government should still take a lead in lifting the country out of poverty through reforms and regulations, but they assert the private sector can contribute largely to that initiative, benefiting all citizens.
Business in nation building
I think in many countries, it has reached a point that global corporations can do more for the poor than their governments.
Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.